Hello everyone, and welcome to the Dirigo Film Festival. In the next few moments, we will be showcasing some of the finest student films we've had the pleasure to watch and analyse as a panel. To all the nominees who didn't get picked this year, and that may be watching, we wish you all luck, and we wish you a successful future. At the end of the screening of the film festival, there will also be an award ceremony, where we will award the top films for each category that they have been nominated for. There is also an award you can help with called the Audience Award, where you can help vote for a film through the straw poll link we have put in the chat. And this can help a film win the Audience Award, which we hope you contribute towards. So please, sit back, relax, and enter into the Dirigo Film Festival.
Thank you. do you think it is? It'd be some kind of fish.
But I ain't seen no pictures nor heard no serious stories of one that looked like that.
No, my friend. I think we've just discovered a new species. And you know what that means?
What?
It means we're gonna be rich. Just think about it. Some science folk will pay good money to examine our fish.
No more
beans and soup. Just gonna be steak for us from now on. And they'll have to name it after us. Because there's a rule. You gotta
make the discovery after the folks have found it.
We're gonna be rich and famous. We're gonna have a legacy. People will remember our names. You hear me?
Aye.
Well, you could at least show some excitement, you stiff. Things are gonna be mighty different round here, believe you me.
Why do you reckon it's got so many eyes?
You what?
They just stare at you.
Don't matter to us. I'm sure the science folk will love it, though. The more eyes, the better.
I don't like it. It looks evil.
Oh, shut your trap. It'd be a real beaut. You're just being rude, you is.
Well, once you're done gawking at that ugly son of a bitch, clear it off the table. I'll be making dinner.
Right you are, my love. Tonight, we're celebrating. A toast. What blessing the high sea doth bring. Health to men and death to fish. They're wagging tails that'll pay for this. Once we done got our pay, 100 bottles of this here drink. What's the matter with you?
What?
You're awfully quiet like tonight.
I ain't feeling myself is all.
Oh, don't be so miserable, my love. Great things lie ahead.
Do we gotta eat with it on the table?
Just keeping it close is all. Ain't no wrong with it being here.
Well, let's sell it quick. I don't like it being here around the house.
Ain't no point rushing and running about. Enjoy yourself. Have another drink.
I just got a bad feeling.
Feelings for poetry. What reason you gotta say that?
Don't matter. Someone ain't right with that fish. It ain't right.
Oh, shut your gob. Ain't now wrong with that fish. For all I care, it could be here for another week. Makes no difference.
Now hold on, you said we were selling it tomorrow. I ain't having that filthy thing round this house a second longer than I have to.
Now don't you go calling it filthy. You ain't got no reason to call her that.
Her? Don't go losing your head now. It's just some bloody fish.
It's not some bloody fish, it's special. And we shouldn't be so hasty selling it to the first two-bit scientists we find.
But you said this was our ticket out of here.
All I'm saying is we ought not to rush things. We should sit on our discovery. Keep around for a bit, until we find the right folks to sell her to.
Stop calling it her. We ain't having it here come morning. So we're selling her tomorrow, or I'm throwing her back in the sea.
Well, you can walk it in for all I care. Ain't no way you're gonna throw our chances of being rich and famous down the bog cause you got a feeling. Pish posh. You hear me? Pish posh. Enough of this foul gab. If the house keeps pouting, I'll give you something proper to pout about.
Just makes me uneasy at being here.
There. You've done it now. If I hear one more filthy word about that fish, it'll be more than a slap. Believe you me.
You've got no right treating me like that. We both found that fish together. So I ought to have some say in what we do with it.
Who saw the fish first, eh? I saw him first.
And who brought him back home? Who did all the heavy lifting? Now we always do things your way. And I ain't complaining, but you gotta hear me out on this one. There's something not right with this here fish. Let's sell it. Or throw it back. I don't care which way. But we've got to do it tomorrow. You hear me?
All right. I hear ya. I hear ya and I respect your opinion, but I think you're soft.
Oh, I'm soft? Well, you're the one that can't even grow a beard, you Nancy boy!
What did you call me? You don't mean it. You know it's not true. I can grow a beard. Look, I have one. I have a beard. You just say these nasty things because you're drunk.
Oh, I'd be the drunk, am I? No, you be the drunk. No, you. No, you be a drunk. No, you're a drunk. No, you. No, you. You lubbering wishy-washy do-beer.
Oh, look at ye, brave little man, ain't ya? Want things done your way now, is that it? Finally found a voice, have ya? Using your foul mouth to insult me looks. Well, it ain't happening. We're keeping this damn fish till I say so. Got a problem with that? Didn't think so. Now enough with this foul spell that grips ya. I'll forgive your talk on account of the drink. But I want to hear no more of this. We rise early. And I don't want to hear another peep of this talk.
Right then. Let's be merry.
Oh, blow the man down, bullies, blow! Well, looky here. I knew it. I knew you were gonna try take her from me. Fixing me for a fool, are you? Taking advantage of a man while he sleeps. But I ain't gonna let you do that.
Now don't be going loony now. You ain't been thinking proper. Let me have the fish.
She's mine! You hear me? Mine! And I ain't gonna let you take her from me. You ain't taking her from me. She's mine.
It's just a bloody thirst.
No, she ain't.
Ain't you see it?
Thank you. With every country, there's a history. Whether one of victory or defeat, culture or tradition, or the untold missing from our textbooks. With every journey, there are hardships. To struggle and fight for all means of survival, one must protect himself from the dangers the world inflicts on him. Between the years 1964 to 1973, 270 million cluster bombs were dropped in Laos. Until today, approximately 80 million UXOs remain on the farmlands.
Obama was surrounded by prosthetic limbs designed for the injured.
We see the victims of bombs that were dropped because of decisions made half a century ago, and we are reminded that wars always carry tremendous costs.
Even until now, many Laos civilians face injuries from the UXOs. 50 casualties happen a year on my family's country, my dad's country. With every man, there was a story. From blood, sweat, and tears, to nights of unrest, explosions, chaos, and screams of terror, he could only hope for freedom. Are you ready?
Yep. Come and yell, see what Jack. We know for you, but they did now. เรื่องประวัติของข้าพเจ้าก็เป็นประวัติที่ยาวพอสมควรจะเริ่มต้นที่ว่าตอนข้าพเจ้ายังน้อยเนาะยังเด็กแต่ก็ชีวิตจริงข้าพเจ้าเกิดอยู่ที่แขกเสียงขวางบ้านน้อยแห่งหนึ่งพ่อแม่ข้าพเจ้าก็เสียไปย้อนสงครามเวียดนามพอเพื่อนถูกระเบิดฉะนั้นข้าพเจ้ามีน้องชาย2 คนแล้วก็น้องสาวผู้นึงเมื่อพ่อกับแม่เสียชีวิตไปแล้ว3ไอ้น้อง4ไอ้น้องก็บ่มีบ่อนอยู่เพิ่นพาอาศัยทุกคนทุกเป็นเด็กอย่างเด็กอยู่ฉะนั้นก็เลยได้แจกแต่ละคนสงครามเวียดนามน้ำมือน้ำแห้งขึ้นมีเฮลิคอปเตอร์จากทหารเวียงจันทน์ไปหาอพยพจากเสียงขวางมาเวียงจันทน์ได้ข้าพเจ้าก็บ่ฮู้จักว่ามันเป็นอีหยังเข้าไปใส่แล้วครับบ่ฮู้จักว่าเขาเฮ็ดหยังแล้วก็เลยมีทหารผู้นึงมาดึงเอาข้าพเจ้ายัดใส่เฮลิคอปเตอร์หนีออกจากสงครามเพราะเวลาเฮลิคอปเตอร์มาครับเอาคนพอมันยังมีสงครามแล้วเขาก็ยิงปืนใหญ่บ่ระเบิดอย่างออมคายทหารอยู่คิดชื่อกว่านั้นถ้าว่ามีทหารผู้นั้นเอาข้าพเจ้าขึ้นเครื่องบินไปใช่ไหมครับจะเสียชีวิตอยู่หรือพอข้าพเจ้าก็บ่รู้จักอายุข้าพเจ้าก็พอเพียงแต่ได้มอง12หรือ13ปีและน้องนุ่งของข้าพเจ้าก็บ่รู้จักว่าป้าเขาเพิ่นไปอยู่ใส่อายุข้าพเจ้าก็พอเพียงแต่ว่า11 หรือ 12 ปีและก็ยังบ่ทันมีเพิ่นก็บ่มีบ่อนเพิ่นพาอาศัยอยู่พ่อบ่มีพี่มีน้องอยู่ในเวียงจันทน์ก็ได้พ่อพี่น้องเพิ่นยังอยู่ในเสียงขวางวัดยังอยู่อันนั้นแข่งเสียงขวางเพิ่นว่าฉะนั้นข้าพเจ้าจึงตัดสินใจว่าตัวเองบ่มีบ่อนอยู่เนาะนวดเป็นสมณีเพิ่นพาอาศัยอยู่ในวัดวาลามคือวัดสีดำดวนแต่ข้าพเจ้าก็ได้อาศัยอยู่วัดภายใน3-4 ปีและได้ไปศึกษาห้ำเหียนอยู่ที่โรงเรียนสมัยเก่าและสมัยใหม่เมื่อโลกสมัยใหม่เขาเทคโอเวอร์สมัยเก่าแล้วทุกคนต้องเป็นอพยพติดต้นย้อนหนีจากประเทศตัวเองและข้าพเจ้าก็รู้จักว่าเขาจะสิไปใส่กันยังบ่ทันใหญ่พอเท่าไหร่อายุเพียงเท่าเลยตัดสินใจข้ามจากเมืองลาวมาเมืองไทยในระยะเวลาที่ข้าพเจ้าข้ามอันก็มันเป็นสิ่งที่ยากที่สุดเนื่องจากว่าตัวเองจากนานี่จากประเทศตัวเองที่เกิดในดินแดนแห่งนั้นจะไปอยู่ไปอาศัยคนอื่นตอนระยะที่เวลาที่ข้าพเจ้าข้ามของเขาจากเมืองลาวมาหาเมืองไทยนั้นเป็นต้นนนี่จากประเทศลาวเขาสู่เมืองไทยในท่ามกลางที่ข้าพเจ้าอนา ใช้เวลาลอยน้ำทำของข้าพเจ้าและเห็นสังเกตเห็นว่าเม็ดคอนี่ยังไหลลงมาในน้ำของนั้นตอนข้าพเจ้ากำลังลอยน้ำทำของอยู่ก็เลยเห็นว่าเห็นศพคนตายคือเม็ดคนเสาพ่อมงเขานี่แหละที่เขาถึกฆ่าตายที่เขาโยนใส่น้ำของที่ไหลลงมาในความเชื่อถือเนาะของศาสนาพุทธตัวเองก็เคยบวชมาแล้วก็สิ่งที่ตัวเองนับถือก็คืออธิษฐานว่าเนอะให้เราไปให้เราสุขดีใช้ขึ้นสวรรค์ชั้นฟ้าซะให้ข้าพเจ้ามีสุขภาพแข็งแรงปลอดภัยด้วยคำนวณเดินทางของข้าพเจ้าเข้าสู่นะชีวิตใหม่ตั้งตัวเองในชีวิตไปตั้งชีวิตใหม่สิ่งตัวเองแล้วก็เลยเอามือสุกนี่ให้มันไหลไปตามแม่น้ำของไปฉะนั้นข้าพเจ้ามาฮอดเมืองไทยและก็เลยได้มาอาศัยอยู่เมืองไทยเมื่อปีพันเก้าร้อยนะ82เป็นอพยพเราที่มาอาศัยอยู่ศูนย์หนองคายศูนย์ทุกคนก็อาจจะรู้จักว่ามันใช้ชีวิตยากถึงขนาดไหนเนาะเพราะมีใครอยากเป็นอพยพจะไปใส่มาใส่ดอกแต่เมื่อนักควบจะเป็นก็ต้องได้ไปเพื่อชีวิตของตัวเองอนาคตข้างหน้าข้าพเจ้าก็เลยได้คลิกสัมภาษณ์จากสถานทูตอเมริกาที่ออกจากเมืองไทยมาอเมริกาปี1980ตกอยู่ที่รัฐเทนเนสซีมาสร้างชีวิตใหม่อยู่ในประเทศสหรัฐและข้าพเจ้าก็คิดว่าอยากทำอยากเห็นหรือเห็นหนังสือหนังสือกับไม่มีเวลาเห็นหนังสือหนังสือพอมาถึงเกษียณที่เรียกเห็นงานแล้วผมมีพ่อไม่มีแม่ได้ไปอาศัยตัวเองอาศัยอยู่ที่รัฐแมสซาชูเซตส์ผมมีสปอนเซอร์เลยจำเป็นใน babysit ให้เขาเจ้าเพราะผมมีเงินที่เสียค่าเรือนเลยได้ babysit ไปส่งหายเรียกงานทำฉะนั้นข้าพเจ้าก็เลยใช้ชีวิตจังซี่นี่แหละอยู่อเมริกาย้ายจากซาบริดไปอยู่พาวิเดนก็เลยจากพาวิเดนเลยมาอยู่มูลสเกตถึงปัจจุบันนี้ข้าพเจ้าได้พบคนรักข้าพเจ้ากับมาจากเมืองลาวก็จะใช้ชีวิตตั้งแต่ year 1999อะไรนี่เด็กไอ้แม่ชื่อมอม1999 after that your mom keep you pregnant you know you might keep you pregnant to get pregnant that's you
when my mom picked me up from school lateI felt embarrassed explaining to her in Laotian that my teacher had been waiting for some time. I didn't know why, but I felt I didn't fit in when I talked in a foreign language in front of other people. Because I was picked on by other kids for bringing sticky rice and papaya salad to school, I had hamburgers instead just to not be an outcast.
So I have been staying in America for a while, like almost 30 years already. In my heart, is in my mind, before I die, I want to go see the country where I born.The lucky if I am, I met my wife, she came from Lao, and I have my lovely daughter, a beautiful daughter. We decide, I want to, my daughter to see the country where I came from. It looks really, really different. It's beautiful.
But growing up, I've started to learn how to embrace my identity. I come to realize there was no need to feel ugly wearing palmai to weddings. They were part of my tradition, and now I feel the most beautiful wearing sin and pabiyang. ตั้งจากใหญ่โตแล้วและมาเรียนรู้ประเพณีของตัวเองของคนลาวและก็ของพ่อก็เลยเข้าใจว่าวัฒนธรรมของคนลาวเป็นสิ่งที่งามที่สุดแล้วก็มาได้เรียนอีกอย่างนึงก็คือว่าพ่อเสียสละให้เฮาเรียนสูงแม้กระทั่งเพิ่นก็อยากเรียนต่อเพิ่นยกให้เฮาที่มีการศึกษาที่ดีแต่ว่าข้อสำคัญที่สุดพ่อสอนก็คือว่าให้รักวัฒนธรรมของคนลาวแล้วสิ่งที่ตอบแทนเพิ่นก็ให้เรียนรักประเพณีของคนเฮาขอบใจเด้อพ่อ
Well done, Chloe. You always were my best student.
Why are you here? Why are you following me? What's going on?
What's got into you? What are you doing to her?
She's harassing me.
Now, Millie.
Sit down. This is actually pathetic. I'm not arguing with you anymore, Millie.
She's a liar, miss. Listen, I didn't touch her. I swear down she is a liar.
Millie, I'm not interested. Save it for Mrs. Allen.
What?
Nothing. What's Mum going to say about this?
What?
Nothing.
Why are you here anyway?
It's a thing for English.
What thing?
A prize.
Let's see then.
So, what did you do?
I didn't do anything.
Okay, who was it this time?
I call Mason. Hockey girl.
Fell over the hurdles last year and made them call an ambulance. Her brother's in your year. Walks like a duck.
Oh yeah, I know. Well, I just went up to her and said, if you've got something to say, then say it to my face. That is it. And now I'm the one in trouble for intimidating behaviour, and guess what's happened to her? Nothing.
Can you just tell Miss Doyle what happened?
Yep, okay.
I'm just saying.
You won't understand.
There are other ways to handle things.
All right, Mum.
Just saying.
Do you ever wonder why no one picks on you?
Why would anybody pick on me?
Because you're tragic and annoying. All right, don't cry about it.
What did Nicole say?
Nothing.
It can't have been nothing.
Just leave it.
I'm only trying to help. Maybe if you apologised.
God!
Just shut up, would you? We are not friends. I don't have to tell you stuff.
What are you doing?
I'm leaving.
What about your prize?
Mum will be too busy now, won't she?
Oh.
Oh, sorry I stole your thunder, oh golden child.
Yeah, you really sound sorry.
It's just a bit of work, is it really that important?
Look, you got what you wanted, I'm leaving you alone.
Hey, give it back!
I'm just looking.
Millie, seriously, stop! But in battle, there is no one quite like her. She's there for you, always. Even when outnumbered, she never backs down. Her greatest strength? Her courage. She wouldn't want you to know it, but she feels fear sometimes too, just like the rest of us. But even when she's scared, she protects her family above all else. And this is why she's a superhero.
Chloe, I don't know what to say.
First time for everything. What did she say to you? Duck girl.
Something about Mum.
What about her?
She knows that woman. Dad's new. Wherever she is. And I told her to stop talking about it. And then I just lost it. I know I shouldn't have, but I couldn't help it. Technically, it was my fault.
You provoked.
I'm always provoked.
You can't let her get away with this. You have to tell someone.
Who would I tell?
Oh. Chloe, I'll need to speak to your sister first, if that's all right. Why don't you head back to your lesson and I'll send for you later. Amelia. Twice in 1 week. Aren't I lucky? In you come.
The mountains and hills of the Cairngorms are battered by the most ferocious winds and bone-chilling temperatures in Britain. It can appear truly inhospitable. Yet there are some creatures that reign over these mountains. And perhaps the most iconic of these is the mountain hare. Mountain hare can thrive on the most heavily managed of Scottish land, grouse moors. Covered solely in heather, they have plentiful food, no animals to compete with, and only a few to fear. They spend their days huddled in forms, watching over our world and retaining heat. Harsh weather can be endless. Still, they stay steady and calm in their opportunistic shelters. But the mountain hare must always be alert, as this is not a land of bliss. It is the land of man and his gun. This is not their only threat.
The mountain hare are creatures of camouflage, and triggered by hormones, their fur will change colour to blend with the season. Brown in spring to white in winter. They will believe they are perfectly disguised and protected from those that have hair at the top of their menu. On a warming planet, the weather is not as it should be. Winters are milder, and without snow, their ingenious disguise now betrays them. Fur designed for Arctic conditions leaves the hares weak against the wind-driven rain and vulnerable to predators. Their survival through winter depends on snow. Once they are at the summit of hills and mountains, they cannot climb any higher. And so they must sit and wait. For the time being, the weather can change in the blink of an eye, and just one night of snowfall can restore the mountain hare's world. They are free to enjoy this winter wonderland. Some make the most of this by stretching and dashing around, before returning to their favourite and familiar form. Others dig for heather and enjoy their meal with a view. But the ultimate luxury is a refreshing roll in the snow, a fur-cleaning bath. These hares are a testament to the remarkable strength of species to endure the harshest environments. They live on the edge of survival, with only ptarmigan and grouse accompanying them. But now their survival depends on us.
Stuff cuts right. Friday. Also, a few special fans' birthdays happen to be today. We've got Julie Withers turning 45, Andy Yang turning 57, Garlo Calicia turning 49, and Alicia Veal turning 38. The Pulse 95 wishes you a happy birthday. Tune in at 5 for more of The Pulse 95.
Got something that I can't go without. It's not good for me, but it really, really gets me high.
It comes from Germany, I want to say, and I guess it's what we have for generations already. Like where we came from in upstate New York, a lot of them do farming, a lot of dairy, some do carpentry, some do cabinet shops. Right up in this area there's a lot of construction, carpentry, sawmills. Whatever we can do, because we can't use the electronics and stuff, so we don't have any desk jobs or something like that. There's a lot of different groups of Amish. As far away as that, it's our group, the same group, all the way down to Kentucky, Mississippi, Tennessee. There's groups. Education goes up to 8th grade. Which we do arithmetic, math, and then spelling. And we have some German lessons. English we have. It serves for our church and, well, for the preachers in church, I guess. They learn it in school, how it is, how it's done. And for, like me, doing construction, carpentry. Doing with numbers and stuff like that, I guess, is, well, it helps with a lot of things. I'm a real big bookworm.
Our mother was a bookworm. I guess we got it from her.
Yeah. But after they get out of the 8th grade, it's mostly working at the parents' side, or older brothers or sisters, or even send them out alone to whatever they can do by themselves. They marry at 21, sometimes later, but it's 21 is usually the age that they get married. Like my dad saying, I have to, it's nothing like that. It's between the boy and girl if they want each other. No alcohol unless we are safe, we can use it as a medicine. We do not have any state IDs or picture IDs.
They don't like us to work on the paper.
It's just small things. I guess they made a line somewhere. Mostly housekeeping. That's housekeeping and I guess taking care of. Yeah. Aaron. The women are supposed to have a covering on their head. Another thing the women do, they sue. Pretty much all of them do suing and get the family clothes, mates, family clothes and. The man is where the income comes from, like the money comes from. Like I go out and work. She's at home taking care of the kids, getting all our food ready and having clothes here for us, does laundry. She's taking care of the stuff in the house, whatever we need. And the man he goes out and does work for money. Some women, if they have time, they do some sewing or something like that to sell, but it's for the most part there at home. I don't think I could make it like that.
I wouldn't mind if you would cook sometimes.
Oh, I sometimes do if we grill. She's got quite a few recipe books. It just comes from wherever she finds them, I guess. Wants to make something different, she goes in there.
Oh, I wouldn't mind if someone else would do it, but I guess that's part of my work.
A lot of times she wants me to say what we want, but I never know what we want. I'm like, you just make whatever. I guess she's good at a lot of things. She learned it from her mom since she was, I don't know, growing up. Our Bible is a high German. We do work 6 days a week, then Sunday we don't work. Day of rest, every other Sunday. Every 2 weeks we have church in the forenoon. We go to church. They take turns, every family takes turns at their house. We don't have a church house. The whole house usually has tables in through and sometimes tables in the basement too. The women are doing, they call them cooks, are doing all that, getting every table ready. In Pennsylvania, I know they call it Rumspringa. So they go out and party and whatnot, I guess, and I never wanted to go away from my family like that.
Well, when you would go away, and you would kind of be ashamed to come back.
Yeah, they want you to come back.
But they don't want you to go. And if you go, you're really like, I come back.
I guess it would be hard to come back. To face the family. I guess however somebody grows up,
it's
what we say.
The way we grow up is the way that we're
Kyle had been hiding out on this beach for 2 weeks now. Too lazy to break up with his girlfriend Karen, but too done with her to stay together. Hiding on the beach, trying to blend in with the sea lions until she presumed him dead was his best bet. Unfortunately for me, Kyle has built up a tremendous capability and shown a real knack for camouflage, having served in Korea. This could take hours. And I miss the sunshine.
Mochi!
Damn, he's good.
Damn, you're good!
Did you see me?
No, you're pretty good at camouflage. I thought it was a normal sea lion.
It was me, Kyle.
How's work been?
Pretty shitty since you've been gone. I mean, seeing Oaks makes it better, but it's pretty shitty. But hey, such is life.
Such is life. You know, I read in a magazine that in Thailand you can stop working after the age of 30. You can work till you're 30 and just stop, and they'll still pay you.
Not sure about that one, Kyle.
True facts, stupid.
I'm not stupid. I'm creative.
So, Mochi, have you seen Kyle recently? He hasn't been into work in 2 weeks. I mean, pretty soon his girlfriend's gonna think he's dead.
No, I haven't seen him around. I also haven't been to the beach lately. Have you been to the beach lately? Where have you been? Been to any good restaurants lately? Where have you been, Oaks?
Okay, nerd.
I'm not a nerd, okay? I like wearing this silly tie because blue's my favorite color, and I like blue.
I like blue too.
That's my friend Ronnie. Today I decided to visit an old friend of my father's.
There's a baby bug around here. Hey, Moch, sense some distress in your future, man.
Shit, I hope not.
Wait, there you go. There's that baby bug again.
Oh, damn, missed it.
Yo, Moch, you ever heard of an Indonesian spotted tree frog?
Ain't you know who spits but what now?
A frog, Moch. A frog with telepathic powers. Your father spent a lot of times with these frogs doing experiments, even some of them on you. Talking about interdimensional forces, you know, before.
Yeah, before.
It's me, your dad. I'm going out for smokes. I'm never coming back.
What is this? Lunchtime for Gizmo?
Ah, cut it out, Gizmo, you prankster. Come on, stop it. I like Ted Danson. Don't say that about him. No, Gizmo, no one was ever debating between you and Ted Danson for the lead role in Cheers. That's just not true. Oh, I don't know, Gizmo. I just think Oaks is so cool, but I get really nervous around her. She's like really charming and I like her a lot, but I don't know what to do about it, you know?
I
thought my robot roommate Gizmo was gonna give me advice about asking out Oaks, but he kept saying negative things about Ted Danson, and the elderly for that matter. It was incredibly, incredibly offensive. It's been a long day. Time to go to sleep.
A frog with telepathic powers. Your father spent a lot of time with these frogs doing experiments. Even some of them on you.
Lately. Oh, I miss the sunshine.
Who are you? Is this some sort of sleep paralysis or something?
I'm KSV. If so much power inside you, Mochi, what are you doing but smoking doobies and lifting cups?
Who are you?
I just told you now, shut up, big nerd. I'm gonna eat you, and all the powers that you have will finally be in the hands of someone who knows how to use them. Yum, yum.
No, I can't play the rules of Holo. Busy invading this man's dreams to eat him and steal his psychic abilities.
It's a weird dream. I think I'm gonna wake up now.
Bruh.
Oh, fuck.
Mochi, I like your shirt today.
Thanks, I... I love your smile, Oaks. When you smile, it's like the whole world lights up and smiles with you. Kylie, you're back at work!
Mochi, I found your dad!
It's me, your dad. I'm proud of you.
So, Mochi, I was in a trailer park. It's been a rough day, and there was a guy stumbling around out there with a big owl, like a really big owl, and he was on his back and just like trying to keep it to like flying, and I went up to him.
And just like that, this gray day started getting a little brighter.
Thank you. نه من دیگه غلط بکنم با اینا قرارداد ببندم. این دفعه با تمام پوسیده تو رفتم تو چاه. آره دیگه جمع بزن، منم اینجا هستم جمعش میکنم. حامد تو کی میخوای بزرگ شی؟ نه چکشون آماده است. تو نگران حساب من نباش، من حسابم پره. نه دیگه خودت گفتی حامل بنویس، منم حامل نوشتم دیگه. حامد پا نشی بیا اینجا دوباره ها. باشه. نه خدافظ. خانم احمدی گرفتی مواد شوینده رو؟
بله. بفرمایید بقیه پول.
نمیخواد باشه پیشت. فقط اینجا رو زودتر تمیز کن، فردا کلاس شروع میشه.
بیچشم. آقا عزیزی دیوارام تمیز کنم.
نه دیگه نمیخواد، از دفعه پیش که تمیزگری کثیف نشد.
نه یه جایش لک داره ها. تمیز میکنم.
خانم احمدی هر کاری دوست داری بکن. فقط کف و پنجره ها رو زودتر تمیز کن برای فردا آماده باشه.
آقا عزیزی داشتم میومدم یه جوونی بچور زل زده بود مؤسسه.
کاری داشت؟
نمیدونم والا.
کجا بود؟
همین پایین جلو در بود.
کسی اینجا نیست که؟
همینجا بود که لابد رفته. کیه؟ با کی؟ بله بفرما.
کی بود؟
یه آقایی بود گفت شما کار داره.
خب خانم احمدی اول بپرس که بعد در رو واکن.
ببخشید من گفتم لابد قرار بده.
چی شد این پول ما؟ من قرار نبودم رو تصفیه کنیم.
صدا تو بیار پایین، پولت آماده است.
چه عجب.
بیا چک روس.
این چیه دیگه؟
چکته.
مگه من 1000 رو به داداشت نگفتم چک قبول نمیکنم؟ چند بار چکتون برگشت خورده؟
اون چک حامد بود برگشت خورد. چک من که برگشت نمیخوره.
چک هر خری بوده. اصلا طرف حساب من تو نیستی که. خودش کجاست؟
از این بابت طرف حسابت منم. حرفی هم داری به من میزنی.
بیا. بی شرف خودش هم اومد.
شاخ شده واسه هم مردی که
وقتی پای داتولود جماعت اینجا باز میکنی بهتر از اینم نمیشه.
تو همه کاری به من چه؟ من فقط معرفی کردم. اصلا از کی تالش دخالت به من دادی؟
یه بار بهت اجازه دخالت دادم این شد.
تو خوبی؟
تو کدوم کار تو الان درست انجام دادی که من الان با خیال راحت بری کار بزنی؟
کی به من اعتماد کردی که بخواد کار به من بدی؟ بچه خوبه که همه چی تو بودی، همه چی تعریف از تو بوده که اصلا هرس منو بده من
حسد رو بدم بری آتیش بزنی دیگه.
به خودم رفت و رسم کلا دوست داری تو همه چی دخالت.
خب تو الان دخالت نکرده بودم که واسه زندان درت می آوردم.
زندان باشم خیلی بهتر از اینکه تو حقمو بخوری. افسانه دست تو
بود من که خسته شدم از جر و اسباب. کجایی تو؟
من ببینم قهر پیدا نمیشه.
خیلی خوب این چکر نهیدی رو زمین افتاده بود؟
چک؟ مگه نبردم با خودش؟
نه دیگه قرار شد نه
چه با خودش برده دیگه.
خانم احمدی ندیدی این پسر چکو از رو زمین برداره؟
نه به خدا من اصلا حواسم نبود.
الو آقا شما این چکو میبری نباید یه رسید به ما بدی؟ همونی که امروز بردی. یعنی چی نبردم؟ اگه شما نبردی بچه کو؟ بازی چیه مردی که میگم چک اینجا بود الان نیست؟ پاشو بیاره. چی میگی تو؟
چی گفت؟
باید برم چه کنم مسدود کنم
مسدود کنم چه بزی یارو بیا تکلیفم هم باش روشن کنم اینجا رو هم بگردیم ببینیم کدوم گوریه
خانم احمدی یه لطفی بکن اون اتاقو بگرد ببین چه کو پیدا میکنی یا نه بله داد نزن بیا بالا تو لازم نکرده بیا من خودم درستش میکنم
چیه؟ اینم موزه جدیدتون رو اسپول مردم رو بپیچونی؟
بپیچونی یعنی چی میگم چک اینجا بود الان نیست
تو الان چی بس کی برداشته؟ به من چه؟ من صد بار گفتم چک قبول نمی کنم اصلا کجا من اون کار این دختره نباشه
آقا عزیزی
چرت نگو به جز تو هیچ لات دیگه اینجا نبوده ما این خانم خوب میشناسیم
زر نکن بابا میشناسیم میشناسیم من اصلا شک دارم این دختره
ما رو بازی نکن تابلو کار قلطه
یعنی
چی
یعنی
دوزه آره دوزه آمد سگی
که باشی
دوزه آمد ساکت ببینو جهت بدم تام صداتو بیار پایین
ببین من اگه شما دوتارو امروز اینجا پول نکنم مرد نیستم حالا بایسته نگاه کن
حفظی پول از حساب ها برداشت شده
رو خدا تمومش کن
بفرمایید خانم احمدی مزدحم شدید.
خانم کارم مونده.
بفرمایید. کجا داری میری تو؟
چیکار به من داری؟
خب یه دقیقه وایسا تو مؤسسه من میخوام برم شکایت کنم.
برو بابا.
زبون نفهمی ها.
عالی بودی امروز
قلبم داشت میامد تو دهنم
یه مدت این دور برای آفتابی نشد تا آقا از آسیا بیفت بگیر دیگه بگیر
Do you ever wonder what you'd do if the world ended? think I'd dance. Yeah, I know. I look ridiculous. But you know that expression, dance like no one's watching? Well, if as far as you know, you're the only person alive in a 10-mile radius, then who would be watching? I wouldn't need to worry about what everybody else thinks of me because there would be no everybody else. I suppose it could happen any number of ways. The apocalypse. The dead could stop being dead. Atomic bombs could rain from the sky. A deadly disease could hitch a ride in humanity. Or a super volcano could get a rude wake-up call. Of course, when all is said and done, everyone you ever knew could be dead. But what the hell, eh? Sure, it'll be the end of life as we know it. But is life as we know it really that great? It'd be the end of responsibility, of debt, of greed, of oppression, of war, of terrorism. No more ISIS and no more PE. No more fossil fuels, corrupt politicians, or maths homework, or detention, or... I think the scariest thing would be the silence. I mean, it'd be peaceful. But it's strange how deafening silence can be. That's why I choose to drown it out. Damn. It's like she knows me. I still have my radio, so I could listen to it as much as I want, as loud as I want, and nobody could stop me from having a good time. Not even old Mrs. Nerg next door. She'd probably be dead too. It's my friend of many voices. Happy voices. It is far, far away. Sad voices. Angry voices. Smooth voices. And the best part? I don't need to speak back. No need to fake a smile, or struggle to find something to talk about, or laugh at a joke you don't get, because everyone else is laughing at it, so it must be funny, right? Right? No fear of oversharing. Or saying the wrong thing and offending it. Or disappointing it. Or letting it down. Losing its respect. Nope. I can just sit there. And listen. I need to have somebody or something to talk to, though. I reckon I'd go insane otherwise. That's why you're here. Drink? I like you. You listen. I feel like you can understand me, and you won't get mad at me like everybody else does. Not that I'd know if you were. Are you mad at me? Why are you looking at me like that?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Who is this?
Who? What? What in the world are you talking about? Look, Freddy, it's getting late and dinner's almost ready, so hurry up home, please.
Oh, but Mom...
No, no, none of that. No, I expect you at the door in 20 minutes, on the dot, or I'm going to take away this week's pocket money. Understood? Did you hear what I said?
Yes, I did. I'll be there.
off your clothes. I feel myself real close to you, and I'm new to this, but I know exactly what I'm supposed to do. I feel things can't stop.
תראי מה אתם עושים!
השנה החדשה נתחיל בפעילות קטנה, כל אחד מקבל גזרת נעל, עליה הוא... שלום, מי את? את התלמידה החדשה, אוליביה, נכון?
מי זאת?
אוליביה מצטרפת לכיתה שלנו, היא הגיעה אלינו מניו ג'רסי, נכון? לא משנה אוליביה, את יכולה ללכת לשבת שם. כל אחד מקבל גזרת נעל, עליה הוא כותב מהי הדרך החדשה שהוא מתכוון לצעוד בה, ואיך הוא מתכוון להתמודד לקראתה. כמובן שאפשר לקשט.
בוא, תראה לי מה כתבת.
Yes, well, I did do that.
תנסה לחשוב מה השאיפות שלך לשנה החדשה.
אוליביה, מאיפה נעליים האלה?
היא לא מדברת עברית. נכון? קומידס. סורי. טונה? מסריח. זרקי את זה. זרקי את זה. Let's see if you can do this. So, Olivia.
Give it back.
הנושא של היום הוא יוני דואר. השימוש ביונים להעברת מידע מתבסס על העיקרון שהיונה תמיד תנסה לעוף חזרה אל ביתה בדרך הקצרה ביותר ובמהירות יחסית גבוהה. בהיסטוריה של היישוב היהודי גם השתמשו ביוני דואר להעברת מסרים, וגם היה שימוש מאוד מעניין באולימפיאדות ביוון. גם בהם, באמצעות יוני הדואר, הכריזו על המנצחים. אני כותבת על הלוח את ההיסטוריה של יוני הדואר.
Thank you.